Good morning. Today is Wednesday, September the 16th. You know, you're probably familiar by now with the term of hypoxemia, but today we're going to talk about the third symptom of hypoxemia, and that is coughing. You know, coughing is designed to expel an irritant in the airways of your lungs that's not supposed to be there. Well, today I want to talk to you about an irritant in the airways of your prayer life that could possibly do a lot of harm to your prayer life. That irritant is doubt. You see, doubt uses reason, a logic, to actually justify and occupy a space in our mind. Here's what doubt sounds like. Doubt says, I do not see, I do not hear, or do not feel. So therefore, I don't believe. It feeds off the natural senses of what you see, you hear, or you feel. Let's look at an illustration in the Word of God that actually helps us to understand what doubt sounds like, what we hear in doubt, and actually what we feel in doubt. Mark chapter 9, verses 24. So they brought him. When the Spirit saw Jesus, it immediately threw the boy into a convulsion. He fell to the ground and rolled out, foaming at the mouth. Jesus asked the boy's father, how long has he been like this? From childhood, he answered, it has often thrown him into the fire to kill him. But if you can do anything, take pity on us and help us. If you can, said Jesus, everything is possible for the one who believes. Immediately, the boy's father exclaimed, I do believe, but help me overcome my unbelief. You see, this father was struggling. He was struggling with what he saw, what he heard, and what he felt. You know, we all have times like that in our lives where we're struggling with our natural circumstances because they just don't align with what we want to see based upon our faith. Today, I want to encourage you, if you're struggling in that area and you're like, you know what, I'm so fixated on the natural circumstances, I can't even see my way out of this. I want to encourage you today to don't allow doubt to enter into your prayer life. Don't allow doubt to enter into your prayer life and begin to build yourself up in faith. How do you build yourself up in faith? The Bible tells us simply, faith comes by hearing and hearing by the Word of God. So begin to focus and meditate upon the Word of God. Begin to see the Word of God. Begin to hear the Word of God. Begin to feel the Word of God. And I guarantee you, you'll build yourself up in faith. You know what? Let me pray with you. Father, we come to you in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father, for everyone, Heavenly Father, that may be struggling with doubt. But I thank you that just like the Father prayed, they will be transparent before God. And they will say, help me overcome my unbelief. Father, thank you, because I know you hear us when we pray. In Jesus' name, amen.